don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay. Do you understand that? Serious crap.
I'm sure none of you have forgotten that very viral video of Alex Jones from a few years ago. Well, apparently that conspiracy theory is coming back. And this time it is RFK Jr. that's running with the narrative. And he did so on Jordan Peterson's podcast.
I've seen the climate apocalypse use fear to induce something approximating the same kind of level of tyranny, as far as I'm concerned, that characterized the vaccine lockdown. Help me sort that out and understand where you stand.
I see these huge levels of depression and despair, loneliness in kids. And I don't think that there's a single cause to it. And I think blaming it on, you know, depression about climate is probably oversimplistic. And in fact, I think a lot of the problems we see in kids, and particularly boys, it's probably underappreciated that how much of that is coming from chemical exposures, including a lot of the sexual dysphoria that we're seeing. They're swimming through a soup of toxic chemicals today, and many of those are endocrine disruptors. There's atrazine throughout our water supply. Atrazine, by the way, if you in a lab put atrazine in a tank full of frogs, it will chemically castrate and forcibly feminize every frog in there, and 10% of the frogs, the male frogs, will turn into fully viable females.
If you thought what he just said was insane, so did the people over at YouTube who removed that video of the podcast Sunday for vaccine misinformation. Now, obviously, Kennedy's retort to that is that it was a blatant interference with the electoral process, although YouTube's argument is that it was spreading dangerous misinformation that could result in people not taking the vaccine and dying. So two sides to that story. But according to him, chemicals in the water are causing kids to be depressed and causing them to become transgender. But yet also, according to Kennedy, if young people decide to get treatment for their depression, they might become a school shooter. I'm not joking. He really said that. Let's pull up this headline from Rolling Stone from earlier this month. RFK Jr. blames antidepressants for school shootings. Quote, prior to the introduction of Prozac, we had almost none of these events occur in our country, he said, speaking to Elon Musk. So let's clarify a few things for Kennedy regarding his conspiracy theories. Kennedy Jr. said atrazine was throughout our water supply before claiming that if put in a tank with frogs, it will chemically castrate and forcibly feminize every frog in there, and 10% of the frogs, the male frogs, will turn into fully viable females able to produce viable eggs. If it's doing that to frogs, there's a lot of other avenues that it's doing it to human beings as well, he speculated. Well, this was confirmed by a 2010 study at the University of California, Berkeley, which said that exposure was highly correlated with low sperm count, poor semen quality, and impaired fertility in humans, and noted that the chemical was most potent in amphibians, as frog skin absorbs atrazine at a much higher rate than the skin of mammals. So we actually don't have to look at the freaking frogs that are turning gay, or according to Kennedy, trans, as a good indicator of how that chemical might actually impact humans, because I'm not an amphibian and I would assume that neither are you. But Kennedy also cited no specific evidence for his claim that the chemical herbicide is turning human males into females, which would be an amazing act of nature. So if there was a shred of evidence, I think he'd be able to cite it quite quickly. But in addition to these comments he made over the weekend, old comments from an resurfaced video from August 2020 have also been released.
You're gonna have the right to compel unwanted medical interventions on us. We, you know, the Nazis did that in the camps. In World War II, they tested vaccines on gypsies and Jews. And the world was so horrified after the war, we signed the Nuremberg Charter. And we all pledged when we do that, we would never again impose unwanted medical interventions on human beings without informed consent. And yet in 2 years, all of that conviction has suddenly disappeared.
Comparing getting vaccinated to prevent death from a pandemic to to the Nazis is a bit of a stretch, aside from the fact that not a single person forced you to be vaccinated. I mean, Jesus Christ, that's akin to Holocaust revisionism. But while we see these comments as and conspiracy theories as insanity, the right is loving them, especially one Steve Bannon. We already know that Bannon had been trying to convince Kennedy for months to run against Biden, but he gave Kennedy praise despite knowing he's not going to win.
Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is not going to win the Democratic nomination. The reason is that hardcore Democrats are not going to vote for him. If you look at the polling, his voters, that 19 to 20 plus percent, whatever it is right now in the polling, are people that voted for Obama twice looking for change, and many of whom voted for Trump in 16.
Cenk, I'll say Steve Bannon's right about one thing, and that's that RFK Jr. is not going to become the president of the United States. But how are you feeling about all this vaccine misinformation that's being peddled from his presidential campaign?
Yeah. So look, I know RFK Jr. a little bit, and he's not a bad guy. He means well. He started down the right road and then took a very wrong turn, in my opinion. And not just my opinion, but the opinion of the overwhelming majority of the scientific community. So when he's talking about chemicals that cause problems, yeah, there's plenty of truth to that. There's forever chemicals. It's a story that we did about a week ago here on TYT. It's a massive problem, and DuPont and other companies knew it was a massive problem all the way in the 1970s. You've got things like Johnson & Johnson doing the talcum powder when they knew it was dangerous, and lawyers sue over that. They win over that, and it actually helps to make our country and our community safer when lawyers do that. And there are some real issues with some of the chemicals. And by the way, that chemical does lead to lower sperm count, as you just saw in that Berkeley study. So that beginning is perfectly fine. Questioning giant pharmaceutical companies, perfectly fine. But you have to stick to the science. You can't then go, well, I heard a dude on Facebook, okay? And I think that dude on Facebook knows better than 99% of the world's scientists. No, sorry, he doesn't. He doesn't, okay? And it's not like the scientists just cover up for the pharmaceutical industry. No, the scientists go, well, no, wait a minute, OxyContin's super dangerous, right? The industry bought off some scientists to say, oh no, it's not. The industry, when it was cigarettes, bought off some scientists to say, no, cancer, what's the big deal? You're not really gonna get it anyway from tobacco. But the overwhelming scientific community consensus was, no, it's gonna give you cancer and it's really dangerous. So yes, the industry is every once in a while, the oil industry does it, buys off a very small number of scientists. But the rest of the scientists are not bought off. 99% of them in India and Botswana and Brazil and Russia and America and China and all these different countries didn't agree because they're part of a global conspiracy to turn the frogs gay. No, no, they're telling you what's real science. And so, look, guys, I mean, it's comical. You gotta know this. So when we're mammals, they're amphibians with the frogs. Not only the fact that the fact we gave you about their skin, etc. But guys, yeah, it could lead to lower sperm counts. Some of the chemicals can for men and humans. We've covered that in the story. But we're not frogs. We don't turn into women with ovaries, with functional ovaries. It's totally a different thing. We don't develop ovaries, that's crazy. Some other animals do, and not just because of that chemical, but because of other different reasons. But we're not those animals. We're a completely different species, and that doesn't happen with us. So it's just, no, sorry, cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. And then he keeps doing it. He said that like the people having to wear masks and take vaccines were worse off than Anne Frank. No, don't say that. That's an outrageous thing to say. And it doesn't help him that Steve Bannon is cheering him on and he's calling him, he apparently thought he was gonna be a chaos agent in the Democratic Party. So if you're seeing people who are supporting RFK Jr. because they hate that they don't have an alternative and they don't really know what he stands for, and there's like anybody but Biden, and he's got the name Kennedy, so they're not guilty. They're just looking, they're desperately looking for an alternative, and I don't blame them at all. If you see people supporting RFK Jr. because he's anti-vaccine and anti-mask and then pro you know, frogs being gay or not being gay or whatever it is. No, those aren't Democrats. They're almost all Republicans pretending to be Democrats. If you're not on social media, you might not see them at all. But on social media, there's now tons of trolls pretending to be Democrats going, I think RFK's got a good point about the vaccine, the mask and the frog. I got a good point. No, you're all right wingers. It's a trolling operation. It's super obvious.
Yeah, and of course, as we see, that's totally baked into his argument as the anti-trans and anti-gay panic and rhetoric there, despite the fact that trans and gay people have existed through all human history long before these chemicals that he's attributing the rise in gay and trans people to have existed, or we would be in frequent contact with.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.